Hello and greetings from Iceland. My day started with a magnitude 3.5 earthquake in Askja Volcano, which would not be newsworthy if it wasn't for the constant ground uplift there since 2021. And I started to refresh my own response plan for Askja Volcano. It takes me less than 2 hours to get to the preferred and likely the only possible viewing platform, and the distance to Askja Volcano from there is less than 60 kilometers, and that is as good as things can get. Askja is on the central highlands. The Highland road closes in September and doesn't reopen until June, sometimes not until July, depending on how the winter turned out. And even if the Highlands would be open when Askja erupts, the Civil Protection Agency would make sure that the area would be perfectly sealed off, especially during the early stages. And during that time period, not even planes could fly over there, because the next eruption, it could easily turn explosive, like the last major eruption in Askja in 1875, which led to mass migration from East Iceland due to the hardship that followed. The 1875 eruption was extremely explosive, like you can see on the pumice fields around the volcano, still today. And after that eruption, the ground above the caldera subsided, water started to accumulate in the hole there and developed into the lake Askja. So what we have now is a huge lake above the inflating magma chamber, or this very exciting Icelandic landscape feature, which could easily become a recipe for a major event. And some scientists say that the magma accumulation there has reached the level of no return. This can only end up with a volcanic eruption, although the build-up could take a while longer. And what can we expect from this sleeping giant? The eruption in 1875, it started after a major tectonic event that shook the ground for months before the eruption started. And although the epicenter was in Askja, we see this lava field by Highway 1, almost 70 kilometers away from the epicenter, since the erupting fissure was 25 kilometers long. So this was a major, major event. And this was shot from the highway. I'm facing south now, and we can see the landmark mountain Herðubreiði there. It is in front of the Dyngjufjöll mountains that surround the caldera, and it is a very complex nested caldera. And despite all the reports about it, they all fail to explain this phenomenon in a language that I can understand. It is, however, a well-established fact that the Askja fissure swarm is almost 200 kilometers long and it disappears into the ocean north of the prairie Melrakkasletta. And it is also a fact that since mid-2021, Askja has been showing clear signs of ground uplift, centered around the caldera, and the magma accumulation is likely at 3 kilometer depth, perhaps less. And the million-dollar question is, of course, how much magma is there? The official number now is around 44 million cubic meters. In September 2024, I can't find any more recent numbers. And if we compare that to the events on Reykjanes, 14 million cubic meters have accumulated there of magma since the last eruption, and the magma chamber that has been feeding the frequent eruptions there, it can store around 30 million cubic meters, and it takes only a few months to fill it up. So this is indicating that the inflow rate to the Askja magma chamber is extremely slow, and these numbers are far away from a Cambridge study where a group of scientists came to Iceland and spent some time up there and came back with a staggering number 10 to 100 cubic kilometers of magma. And that number left Icelandic scientists shaking their heads, and this didn't get any usable media coverage. So Icelandic scientists, they had clearly some doubts about this study. And this means that numbers about magma accumulation under there are not very reliable, I have to say. which is strange because every week we get the latest figures on magma inflow into the magma chamber, feeding the frequent eruptions on the Reykjanes Peninsula, while scientists remain silent about the situation by Askja, despite rather dense network of sensors there and frequent INSAR images. And I don't see experts complain over the lack of sensors by Askja. They always whine when they need money for some gadgets, just like me when I need gadgets for my channel. So this monitoring system up there is far from convincing when I compare it to the information we are getting from Reykjanes and elsewhere in Iceland. One of our experts just mentioned Askja briefly only days ago in terms of what volcano will be the next to erupt. And I would have preferred a bit more explanations. And a small or a moderate eruption, even under the lake, it doesn't have to be a major disaster. Like between 1921 and 1930, around nine eruptions occurred there. All of them were quite small. And one of them left us with this little island in the middle of the lake. So Askja eruptions don't have to become the disaster that struck in 1875. And I'm leaving a link to a 20-minute long video about that event. I actually want to remake that video someday with all the new footage that I have since I made it. But the historical information there are still fully valid, or the full story of the 1875 eruption. And I'm also leaving a link to a recent video where I was driving through the lava from 1961, the last eruption in Askja. It's not a guided tour, but it gives you an idea about the out of this world landscape up there. While I'm driving around the mountains surrounding the caldera. And one of the filming goals I've been working on is to film the entire Askja system. And since it's almost 200 kilometers long, it's not an easy task. So I've been working on it bit by bit. This is a task for the drone, and I'm trying to keep a short distance between drone takeoffs as possible. And some of the regions have more dense road network than others. So this is a bit tricky, but I believe that I won't regret it, although it could take me some years to finish this. And the earthquakes today, although they might not be a significant part of the chain of events there so far, were this fine excuse to monetize some of my shots from this long journey of mine chasing the Askja system. And the earthquakes didn't come as a total surprise. Askja has overall been behaving quite well, meaning that the magma chamber might still have plenty of room for more, and it can expand way more before we get some serious earthquakes there. And the question that remains after this day is, are we getting closer to the threshold? Will the seismic activity continue to grow in the coming days? And are we about to get closer to a once-in-a-lifetime event, although scientists remain too silent about this possible scenario in terms of magma volume? And I'm ending this today with footage from 2023, shot from Highway Number 1. And I'm leaving a location link if you want to look at this better from a 3D map. And this is as close as we can get if and when something happens by Askja. This filming location was just a test, but the visibility was good, so the topography pops well. It is, however, the mountain herðubreið that rules this frame with its siblings. And then we have the Dyngjufjöll mountain range behind the herðubreið. The caldera rims are 1500 meters above sea level, and the caldera floor lies at 1100 meters above sea level. And what I'm about to show you is the bigger picture, with long panning shots showing the landmass slope from central Iceland all the way down to the north coast. And when we look at the panning shots from south to north, the highlands look from a certain perspective as a huge shield volcano with this extremely long slope of lava. And I was very grateful for the visibility this day. And this was actually shot 2 drones ago. So today I have a way better zoom lens. And in addition to that, I have the super zoom camera that may likely be the best camera in the world during the first days when Askja takes off. So I am as well equipped for this task as I possibly can. Because I knew it all along that it would be totally up to equipment, how photos and videos will turn out. I actually bought the super zoom camera 3 years ago. It has been a totally useless investment so far, but I suspect that when I will need it, I will be very grateful for having it around. And now I'm going to find some appropriate tunes to play with this video, where I will demonstrate the core of Iceland from the center to the coast. So enjoy the view, and with that I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island Iceland.
Thank you.